CBS America presented by Newegg. We got food in the house. The audience is happy about that. It's dinner time. One person's happy about it. Two series are over. Two more remain. And yes, we did have to say goodbye to Scarlet and Hawk. But don't fret, my fellow Americans, because Captain America himself, Polt, will be playing in the final series today. But coming up next, Bomber versus Pig Baby. Now this is going to be a treat for all of us because in the round of 16, Bomber called out Pig Baby. He wanted to face him today on this stage. And we're going to find out if Bomber can have the rematch he wants or if Pig Baby will continue on in the series. Best of five, single elimination. The winner moves on to tomorrow. The loser goes home. Pig Baby needs to win first place to make it to BlizzCon. Bomber is going to BlizzCon no matter the outcome of this tournament. However, he wants to go as far as he can to have the best seating possible. To help break down more of the storylines for these two players, we get ready for the match. It's my pleasure once again to kick on over to the commentators, Nathanius and Rotterdam. Gentlemen.
Thanks, Clutch. This is a match that we've been excited for a long time about, Roddy. Bomber Pig Baby, I think it's fair to say that Bomber's become one of my favorites this year. His performances have really gone above and beyond my expectations for him.
Yep, recently, of course, he was victorious at the Red Bull Battlegrounds in Washington, D.C., an extremely stacked tournament with five players that were that season or the last season participating in the GSL Codas. One of them in the quarterfinals, one of them even made it to the semifinals with GSL Codas, but Bomber, he defeated them all. He only dropped two maps in that entire tournament, and that was like in a time span of like 6 minutes. One time he lost a bunch of medevacs with a lot of bio units in it, and the next game the opening just didn't go that well, but even that didn't shake him up too much. He still went on to win his semifinals and eventually won the grand finals 4-0. It's safe to say that Bomber is back and he's better than ever. He's just a man on fire right now, Nick.
Yeah, it's been a good year for Bomber. And you know, we could say the same for Pig Baby. He was the unknown. He was the wild card going into season two of WCS America. We didn't know anything about him. He played in some early GSL games. He played in some early Pro League games in Wings of Liberty. But there were no Heart of the Swarm results to look at. There was no VODs we couldn't even find of this guy just to try to study him before he played his matches. And then he turns up and wins the whole entire thing with some really great play. And
he didn't just win it. Yeah. He was amazing. Like in the quarterfinals against Tasia, he made all those observers made all the people here fall in love with him. The semifinals, he went up against the reigning champ back then, Hyun. He was able to defeat Hyun as well, 3-1. And of course, he had that ridiculous final against the man that's currently standing next to him. But before we go ahead and hop into the veto process, once again, we sat down with the players just to know them a little better.
Hello, I am Bomber, and I am playing Terran for Red Bull and SanDisk.
일단 뭐 3-1에서 앞서 가다가 4-3으로 역전된 것은 약간 아쉽지만 그래도 2등도 상당히 괜찮은 성적이라고 생각을 하고 제가 부족했던 부분을 알 수 있었기 때문에 많은 연습을 했고 이번 시즌에는 똑같은 실수하지 않고 이길 난 다시 만나게 된다면 이길 수 있도록 하겠습니다. (목소리) 말씀하셨다시피 일단 C조가 다른 조에 비해서 쉬운 건 제가 보기에도 그런 것 같고 그래서 물론 손이 빠르거나 좀 멀티태스킹에 능하면은 그렇지 않은 선수에 비해서 유리한 건 사실이지만 이 부족한 부분을 충분히 전략이나 심리전으로 극복이 가능하다고 생각을 하고 있고 실제로 그렇게 이득을 많이 보고 있는 편이라고 생각합니다. 좀 더 알아본 결과 내년까지 1년 더 할 수 있는 것 같아서 잘 풀린 것 같아요. 그리고 그거와는 별개로 블리즈컨과 WCS 같은 경우에는 제가 가장 중요시하는 대회이기 때문에 정말 열심히 하고 있습니다. I'm Bomber. You are watching WCS America.
저는 23살 프로토스 양희수입니다. 우승을 하기 전에는 조금 은퇴에 대한 생각도 많았는데 우승을 하고 나서 계속 열심히 할 생각이 많아졌어요. 아직 우승을 했지만 아직 팀을 못 구했기 때문에 남은 목표를 달성하고 멧돼지로 진화하는 걸로 하겠습니다. 저번보다는 그래도 이번이 좀 편하고 긴장도 덜 되고 좀 마음적으로 좀 편해진 것 같아요. 일단 프로게이머 16명 중에 속한 건 굉장히 게이머로서 의미가 큰 것 같고 그리고 더 열심히 할 수 있게 되는 동기부여 같은 게 되는 것 같아요. Hi, I'm Pig Baby. You are watching WCS America.
나이스 투 히어 프롬 디스 투 어메이징 플레이어스 앤드 위 아 게팅 레디 투 홉 인투 더 서드 쿼터 파이널 오브 더 데이. 잇츠 어 리매치 오브 라스트 시즌 라이크 위 세드 멀티플 타임스 앤드 어버브 올 잇츠 소 머치 모어 포 픽 베이비. 블리스콘 이즈 온 더 라인 앤드 네이트 썸씽 댓 위 워 토킹 어바웃 애즈 웰. 이프 픽 베이비 우든트 메이크 잇 투 블리스콘 히 우드 비 더 퍼스트 플레이어 에버 투 윈 어 WCS 챔피언십 앤드 낫 액츄얼리 플레이 앳 더 그랜드 투너먼트 앳 더 엔드 오브 더 이어.
Yeah, I mean last year it was a lot easier cuz if you were able to make it into that top four, you were going to the season finals guaranteed, and then there were points to pick up on top of that. But this time around, it's not as easy as just winning your region. Pig Baby has not actually competed in anything outside of WCS. That's all he's done. He's one of the only players to do so.
Yeah, he came very close to qualifying to the Intel Extreme Masters in Toronto. The only players that he lost to back then in the qualifier were Flash and Zest, the two players who also ended up winning the entire thing, or at least make it to the final of the entire thing. So safe to say that Pig Baby is a very strong player, and he has shown it at more than one occasion, but he hasn't gone to the DreamHack to collect those points. He hasn't gone to a Home Story Cup or other IEM events to collect all those WCS points throughout the entire year. Bomber, of course, a little bit of a different story. Bomber, not really a Heon player that goes to every tournament. I think he more, like, he looks at his calendar, he looks at his agenda, and he's like, all right, you know, that tournament and that time of the year, that looks like a tournament I want to go to. But above all, he still participates in a lot of other tournaments, and of course, all the Red Bull tournaments as well.
Yeah, I mean, you had Bomber, who has just been picking things up slowly this year. He's played in a lot of the North American tournaments that we've been able to see, and He's had a good couple runs in WCS, so I'm looking forward to seeing him, mostly because this match, he's won a big championship this year in the Battlegrounds DC, taking out players that, you know, you could argue Bomber a year ago wouldn't be able to beat, and it's shown that he's been on his A game. But I feel like beating Pig Baby for him is going to be more about
prestige.
Laying the smackdown.
Yep. He knows it as well. He caught him out. We take a look at the map veto process real quick. As Catalina was Pig Baby's veto, Litut would definitely agree with that because he thinks it's a very difficult map for Protoss. Foxrot Labs is going to be the veto of Bomber. And we kick things off on Overgrowth. So things are back to normal in the StarCraft 2 universe, Nate. No crazy shenanigans anymore.
Back to Overgrowth, right?
Yes.
Everybody get comfortable again. It's okay.
If we just watch a series that doesn't have Overgrowth, it's just set in stone that the next one has to start on Overgrowth. Now, Overgrowth is a map that... Yeah, obviously I like Overgrowth. Everybody kind of who loves SC2 loves Overgrowth. But I do feel in this matchup it became a little stale. And very often do you see it come down to that one big engagement towards the third base of the Protoss, where he has a bunch of Blink Stalkers and he has a Colossus or two or three or maybe four. And then he casts Photon Overcharge on his Nexus, and he tries to keep the Colossus alive. If he keeps the Colossus alive, if he keeps that Nexus alive, most of the time he wins the game. If he doesn't have the tools in the right place to shut down the Vikings, then most of the time Terran players win. That's how a lot of PVTs play out on this map in this day and age. Do you think we're going to see it this time, or do you think with these two we can see anything and it's possible that it's going to be different?
It's on Pig Baby to do something out of the ordinary in that instance, because Bomber, I mean, you know, it's not a slight at Bomber, because lots of Terran players in this current day and age, you said, are like this. I'd be surprised if all of these games unless there was some sort of early cheese, didn't end with him going for a big SCV pull and just trying to drop the hammer as Pig Baby takes his third base. You know, he's like the opposite of someone like Pult, who never pulls his SCVs. You do not see Pult go for strategies like that. Bomber, he'll pretty much pull them every single game if he has a chance.
I mean, that was even back then in 2013, WCS Season 2 Global Finals at Gamescom. He played a couple of Protosses on his way to the semifinal, and that's just what he did. You know, he made a couple of harassments, and all right, then he sits back, then he pulls the SCVs, and he marches across the map, and he wins. I think, personally, the best way to play PvT against Bomber is you can open up with two Colossus, that's absolutely fine, but after that, rush into High Templars as soon as possible. Because I believe if you only make two Colossus, then you have enough time to get High Templars out. And against having a couple of Storms against a Terran player, that's pretty much the guarantee to pull his SCVs. Often you find yourself in a really good position.
Yeah, I mean, your basic goal is to just not take so much damage at the start of the game that SCV pull can actually kill you. But looking, of course, at Pig Baby, he's teamless for a very long time. He was the champion for Season 2. And this tournament has a lot more than just winning a rematch against Bomber.
This is one of the series, once more, that if Bomber is able to win it, I think Jaydong at home might just take another sip of the champagne bottle that he's been sipping on, because then he's like, all right, that's one more Dutch bullet and just one more to go. Right now, Jaydong is Bomber's biggest fan in the world, and that's crazy to think of, because of course Bomber did defeat Jaydong once upon a time 4-0 in a grand final, but I'm pretty sure Jaydong forgot about that right now and is just cheering for Bomber. Sitting at home, maybe for once in his life, Jaydong is drinking a Red Bull instead of that other drink that he's sponsored by. Because he's like, all right, go Bomber.
If I was Jaydong, I would definitely be on Bomber's team right now. As this is a big match. Pig Baby showed last season that he can win it all. And doing it one more time would give him, it feels weird to say it, it would become his biggest achievement because he gets to go to BlizzCon. But this guy is in his way. A madman of Terrans himself, Season 2 runner-up from Red Bull, he is Bomber!
Yeah. I must say that Red Bull logo next to the command center looks really well, like that red command center with that logo next to it. Anyways, over here in the left bottom side of Overgrowth, give it up for the reigning champion of WCS America, it is Pig Baby.
Showed us in his offline debut how good really heavy observer openings can be, Roddy.
Yes, we know that he loves them, but since then he has shown a lot of variety in his playstyle as well, because we thought after he did it against Teja, he's going to do this against Bomber as well, because it went so well for him, but none of those games, and it went all the way to the end. We saw all 7 maps played out last season in the grand finals. None of those games was really like the games that he played against Teja. And even this season, again, Pig Baby was able to defeat Teja. So we know that his PvT is still good. I'm excited for this one, Nate. I really am. I find it so hard to call. It's so easy to lean towards Bomber because of the recent success he had in the last few months. And every time I think that Bomber is not going to cut it, he just proves me wrong. Like going into DC, I thought he was the least likely player to win the tournament, actually. Did he prove me wrong? He barely lost a map doing it. So
yeah.
It's really hard though. But Pig Baby, there is so much on the line for him. You guys saw it once more. 2,500 WCS points is what he's currently sitting on. Pig Baby is one of the two players that is still able to knock Jaydong out of the top 16, which means, of course, that Jaydong will not be participating at the grand final of WCS later this year.
Yep, it's up to Pig Baby to take that spot from him, or potentially Hero. Of course.
Still a lot of shoutouts as well. Keep the tweets coming. Hashtag WCS. We really enjoy hearing from you guys. Let us know if you're having fun watching the broadcast. And of course, let us know where you're watching from and who you're cheering for. Special shout out to all my fellow Europeans who are pulling all-nighters. I know, Nate, if I was in Holland right now, I'd be up. I'd be watching you. I'd be like, hey, who's that guy with no beard?
Well, he's doing his gray face cosplay, most likely. SSTV did a nice job of trying to delay this command center from being placed for Pig Baby. He does start his robotics facility before the Nexus.
Wow.
And before a Mothership Core, even.
What? All right, this is really old school, guys.
Well, This could be weird.
This makes me think of that one night where we casted Letut satellite tournament.
That night.
That was pretty. Yes, that night, Nate. That night. There might be some evidence on YouTube about that night. It was a great night. But one of the things that happened as well on that night is that we casted a random PVT. Or actually, it was a PVZ, but it doesn't really change anything. Where a guy went for a one base Sentry Immortal all in, and we all thought that was ridiculous. There were two Grand Master League players going up against each other. We're like, ha! One base Immortal Sentry. That can't possibly work.
And then it worked.
Yeah, and then it worked. And we're like, well, maybe, Nate, we had one too many.
Yeah, there's the Immortal. So this is occasionally a thing in Protoss versus Terran. It's kind of fitting that we have Huck here. We've seen him bust this out himself, and it's with variable success. Ooh. Especially usually it's a map dependent build, but Bomber, yep, as you can see, the way he has his Marines spread out, it's in a position where if you're a Terran player and you're not sure what your opponent's doing, you always have to respect the possibility of a Stargate opening. And Pig maybe could be counting on catching Bomber out of position.
Like, he is getting that second base, of course. That Nexus is about to finish up, but this Nexus is a little later than it normally is. These Immortals are going to be out a little quicker. Good news for Bomber is that he opened up with three Rexes. That's pretty much as good as he could do against his build.
He didn't build any add-ons yet. Like, he is just going ham on his production for Marines. Yep.
And as soon as Bomber identifies this, he's going to have to throw down another bunker or two. Of course, it's always nice how Bomber lets those missile turrets only go up to 24 seconds. If there's an Oracle, he completes it. If not, then he's going to cancel it. It's all the small things. But Bomber, if you haven't watched him play over the last few months, Bomber is the greediest Terran in the world. Bomber does not scout, Bomber does not scan, and Bomber will cancel everything that he doesn't need.
Yep, Bomber will absolutely be the greediest player humanly possible if you open that door for him. So there's two Immortals on the map.
And then Warp Prism
moving out
as well.
The sentries, the Warp Prism is going to be following this up. There are pylons linked very close to Bomber's base. And
this
just
is so
one
quick,
bunker.
Nate. This is 7 minutes in the game. Now, the good news once again for Bomber is that he opened up with three Rexes. So he has pretty much as many units as one can possibly have.
Oh
my god, his spider
sense. But I don't think it's going to be in time, right? He needs to get his Marines out of his main. Yep. It'll only take one force field to completely lock him out. He needs to get down
this
that ramp.
This is so good, though. Like,
oh, the Warp Prism could actually just shuffle up. Oh, no.
Everything? Everything? No. I don't think it's going to happen. Well. Okay, so it's just still one bunker, but there are a lot of Marines. These Marines have a lot of DPS. If they get close to the Immortals...
close to the Immortals, he's picking up a few of the sentries.
Oh, the Marines on the right
there's
side.
There's a hole in that force field wall, Roddy. One Immortal taken out is a huge pickup. Another one very, very low. There's not really a lot of Zealots to slow down the Marines from advancing on this army.
Okay, he really needs that bunker. He knows if he picks up the Immortal, then that bunker is not going to fall anymore, but the Immortal is still alive, and this bunker, there is a chance it may not finish off.
Barely picks off the SCV right before it finishes up. And Bomber's going to be forced onto one base. He has his factory, no starport. Mm. Without medevacs, without stim,
he needs to fly his command center over. He needs to fly it over, otherwise it's going to die. It took him a little while. There is not crazy amounts of DPS in this Protoss anti-air army, but it might be enough. No, I think there will be SCVs to repair it. It's going to be close.
Really awkward. Okay, SCVs makes it to their loving embrace. Force fields are going to try to lock a few of them out, but that command center shouldn't die.
All right, so now we have 25 SCVs for Bomber. Only 23 probes for Pig Baby. Like, if you don't look at the income tab, you might be like, oh, this game is pretty much over, right? I would say the opposite is true, because Pig Baby's economy is terrible. Bomber on... Oh, he needs to repair that command.
Fix your command center.
Bomber.
He's done this before. Yeah, he's made us very... I'm very uncomfortable.
He does this on purpose.
Oh, goodness. Okay. It's down to like 60 hit points. Whew, okay. One SCV is like, fix everything.
Did he just send it back? No, never mind. Oh, so there was the other one.
He's got a big job.
So now we have a very awkward scenario because Pig Baby, he's like, well, I got him contained, but I don't really have a great economy, so I guess I have to keep this up for a while to make sure that this is worth it for me. Bomber, his factory, and Starport are switching locations now. You know, if I'm Pig Baby, I'm not very secure about this yet, Nate. Not at all. In a weird way, I would say that this game is still relatively even, or maybe I even like Bomber's
position. I mean, you've got Stim. If those medevacs finish, Bomber just drops his army outside of his natural Stims and he kills this whole Protoss force.
A really good use of Hallucination, because Pig Baby needs to be aware of the fact that medevacs will be out soon, and then he needs to just drop a force field on this ramp now and get out of here.
Yep.
Well done, Pig Baby. All right, so now the game continues. That was fun.
Well, an explosive opening, and we seem to find ourselves in a very standard PVT position again.
Bomber, like, the moment he sees one Stalker and a glimpse of a probe, he's like, all right, second bunker.
And it almost,
I don't know what it is, but I know you're about to attack
me. I mean, if you hold your natural against a build like that, you are, as you know, from a Terran perspective, I feel you feel phenomenal.
I really like this. A couple of Zealots are going to obviously not kill a crazy amount of SCVs, but it will slow Bomber down. And this is what Pig Baby needs, because right now Pig Baby has nothing that's good against Stimmed Bio. Ooh, Pig Baby's playing with fire here, though. I think he might end up losing the Warp Prism.
This is a big pickup for Bomber. Gets the Warp Prism.
That's bad, because now Pig Baby is just sitting back. There's really no ability for him to attack anymore, unless he warps in Zealots on the right top side of the map.
He has no observers, so the ones these pylons get
cleaned
up.
That's a first, Nate.
Yeah, that is. Well, the thing is, without the observers, how do you know that this big drop's coming, unless he flies right by the pylon? Well, that'll also do it.
Yep. He doesn't have observers, but he does have pylons that will do the job
for him. This pylon should die. There you go. At the very least, he's going to kill it.
But this is still really important, because right now, if you take a look at Pig Baby's army, there is only one Colossus.
He is using a lot of Hallucinated Phoenix to scout too, though.
Yeah. No, it's important, because his army wasn't ready to fight up to fight against the Stim Bio army. But now he bought a little bit of time for himself. Bomber had to chase that Warp Prism, and all these seconds make a huge difference, because a Colossus in an army or not changes everything. There are force fields. I think Big Baby should be okay over here.
I like he just like targets the Nexus, takes 500 health off, and he's like, okay, back off. Yep.
Photon overcharge as well, of course, always nice to take away some of that energy on the mothership core. Don't want to give Protoss a comfortable state of mind.
Don't want a Protoss to sit with full energy on that bad boy, that's for sure.
Oh, that robotic facility is still in that awkward position. Bomber is going to try to, he's a little bit inside. He could actually pick up everything now and fly to the main base. I think that there is a realistic possibility for him to do
maybe
some damage.
Maybe he's moving out of the watchtower. Yeah, Bomber, you could just jump in.
You think he's going to try to sandwich his army?
I don't think I think with just Marines, he doesn't have enough. Like, Guardian Shield and Force Field should be
enough. He has like two Marauders in the mid. No, he has four. I think he could sandwich his army, Nate. I think he should go for it. Like, he has still has vision on this army. Bomber could be setting himself up so nice, because Pig Baby left a lot of units at home.
Oh, boy.
And Force Fields, I mean, they can go down. Oh, one Colossus gets sniped perhaps as well. Well, Colossus are pretty good against Marines, but eventually it should still die.
Nice pickup. Nice pickup for Bomber. Pig Baby's moving out, though. He's got that pylon to help reinforce. Starting another one. Bomber's Factory sees the Protoss army approaching. There are two bunkers and four Vikings. This is actually really, really close.
Yeah, I think if he repairs the bunkers properly, this is actually going really well for Bomber. He gets sort of a rolling fight with these Vikings. Picks up one of these Colossus. Already picked one, of course, on the other side of the map. These Stalkers are not breaking these bunkers, at least not yet. And I think if Bomber gets all of his forces together, he should be in a really good position.
And then the medevacs get back home. Two of them going to get picked off. He unloads. He really just needs to get rid of that Colossus. Yeah. That one Colossus anchors this so well.
Marauders are looking for an opportunity. They're getting close.
Steps forward. He's got it. Medevac comes back. So two medevacs. He's got a couple of Vikings now. But I mean, just a bunker against Stalkers.
And these Stalkers have no blink. These Stalkers have no blink. Even if they had blink, then it would still be a difficult story. But now they have no blink. This Protoss army looks a lot more intimidating than it actually is. Like, no, you cannot fight. You have to run. You have to pray that these Marauders won't chase you.
You do not fight against Marauders. You might think being up 3-1, Stalkers versus Marauders works, but not when there are medevacs on the map.
And they have that Stim button as well. Pig Baby is still going to try. Vikings can land as well. The SCVs are being pulled. The bunker's taking quite a bit of damage, but you know, these Stalkers just don't have the same DPS as this Terran army. It's deceiving because it looks like, hey, Protoss has a lot of units, right? But this Terran army, Nate, this Terran army is a lot stronger than this Protoss army.
You need those Colossi. You need the Stalkers to keep the Vikings away from your expensive big boy Colossi. Without those,
is almost game.
It's not going to work.
This is really bad right now for Pig Baby. He doesn't really have Forges. He doesn't have a Twilight console. He doesn't have Charge or Blink. Bomber actually has Triple Orbital. I didn't even know that. So now he's in an extremely good position.
I mean, he's got his plus two about to finish.
I knew he was in a good position regardless, but it's actually very, very good. As now SCV count doesn't even really matter to Bomber anymore either. Pig Baby is still going to try to hang in there, but he will soon to be a one-base Protoss, as Flo is showing us. His main is pretty much mined out.
He manages to spot these drops coming in, but with this little economy, you can't really afford to warp anything in to help deal with this. So, this is about as tough a position as me. I love this. Picks off a Stalker. Picks off both Stalkers.
Well done. good focus
There's
fire.
Nothing that can really kill the Metamax. Now you can just fly around all day.
It's always risky to do stuff like that because I'm sure you as a Terran player can confirm if you like misclick, then
yeah.
your Marauders
well,
run
you
away.
Well, you misclick, all your Marauders die.
Yeah, and they run away from the Metamax and you try to pick them up, but they just scatter all over the place.
Yeah.
You're like, no, get back to the chopper.
But when you kill those Stalkers, it's so nice because you know that Stalkers are really expensive. In like the 4 Protoss games I built, I'm like, man, Stalkers are actually not cheap units at all.
That is correct. Pigbay right now, of course, there is so much on the line. This is a massive tournament. You don't want to leave as long as you have a Colossus and you have a mining base. But Pigbaby knows that he's definitely on the ropes and he's really going to need a couple of miraculous engagements, or he just needs Bomber to pull a Bomber and put like 6 Medivacs full of units AFK in a side of the map and then hope that he snipes them
off. That, you know, that is one way to win a game.
Yeah, that would bring it back. Bomber is going to clean up a couple of these pylons as well on the
I'm
right
impressed
side.
That Bomber builds the bunker and takes a gas at his third.
Yeah, like why did he not pull SCVs?
Yeah, he's actually not comfortable enough to pull SCVs against a Twilightless Protoss. Like, there's no threat of storm.
I think it's mostly just the lack of Vikings, because like pulling SCVs is exciting and all, but if you have no Vikings, then 4 Seals can actually mess you up, even if you have 40 army supply lead. You pretty much need something to fight against those Colossus while the Force Fields are going
That's
down.
I guess because he also lost a rather large number of SCVs this game.
There's no anti-air in that army. There are 2 sentries.
All these Colossi and Stalkers. Maybe some Zealots. Can't do anything.
Man, Bomber has scanned a lot in this game. I'm impressed. This is really Bomber.
He finally fixed that hotkey button.
Yeah. What does this button do?
I had scan unbound forever. I thought all I could do was mule. Is this how you attack? Like,
look at Bomber.
Really?
Like, his army is still in Metavax. This is ridiculous, but it's beautiful if you are a Terran player.
You know what?
Wow.
Even as a Terran, that is like that engagement.
Yeah.
It's like you walked under 4 Metavax. You know, it's as if those Metavax are just like invisible when they're not moving.
And look how stone cold he is as always. It doesn't even like. He's like, yeah, I did that. Like,
it's like, I almost lost to your immortal push, but.
Yeah, in the end, it wasn't really all that impressive. It's going to have to be better. He's like, all right. Well, it's a great game already. Great way to kick off this series. I think pretty back and forth. It was really hard to call at times. Like, at first, it looked like, oh, this Immortal only might work. But then, like you said, the forces were slightly out of position and a couple of Marines squeezed through on the right side between you know, the main base and that force field. And that really allowed those Marines to push out more damage on those Immortals.
If that force field is in a proper position to stop those Marines, like, It's a really, really big deal. And then when you make a defense like this, the 2 bunkers...
Look at these Vikings, by the way. All
these
3 damage.
They get 2 full volleys off before the Stalkers even begin to shoot. Yeah. And one Colossi, you know, it seems like, okay, you know, you still got another one, but those 2 Colossi is such a huge difference compared... Because the Stalkers we saw in the follow-up fight, like, they just die to bio. It doesn't really look like a fair fight. No.
They also clump up and they will prevent each other from shooting if you have a certain amount that you can't micro them anymore. It doesn't really get the job done. It's really
and
important,
flank,
of course.
I think it's important to know, like that little flanky attacks from the back, which prevents the Stalkers from stopping those few units from running ahead and sniping that Colossus.
And of course, that product placement. Bomber knows what he's doing, Nate.
He's becoming a legend.
Yeah. Of course, that one Colossus he picked off on the south side of the map as well. Like, for a moment, I thought there was a window of opportunity for him to perhaps sandwich that army in the middle of the map. Like, if he grabbed everything, it would have been risky, but I think it would have been possible with 4 Marauders coming in from different angles. But instead, he just picked off Colossus number 3 that was all by himself. And that would have been a fantastic position, because it's a world of difference making a push with either 2 or 3 Colossus. Because if you only have 4 Vikings against 3 Colossus that are knocking on your front
then,
door...
Well, then you're in a...
Even if you get 2 free volleys off, there are still 2 other Colossus full on HP that...
You die.
Yes. So, really, really important little pickup there. A lot of small moments in this game. Very interesting game of StarCraft. And it's good to see Bomber just... Still continuing his tier. He must be pretty high on the Alagulag rankings by now, no? It feels like every single time I cast Bomber, he's winning, so he must be collecting a lot of points.
He has been winning a pretty reasonable number of games, to say the least. He gets some pretty damn good opponents, too. Like, he was one of the guys he beat in the championship for Battlegrounds DC, Cure, who was a semi-finalist for GSL Code S this season.
Yep. And I mean, he 2-0 Dongregu as well, who was in the quarterfinals.
Yeah.
Overall, Bomber has been on an absolute tier. runner ever since he stayed at our apartment, Nate. Like, I really wish that we would have just
told
him to sign a contract, 10% commission for the rest of your tournaments over this year. We would have been rich, Nate.
We would be balling out for
sure. Yes. And it would all be due to Bomber. Unfortunately, we did not make that deal, but I'm still very happy for him as he's an awesome guy and he's a great StarCraft 2 player. And he definitely deserves it. Map number 2 of this quarterfinal is going to be played on King Sejong Station. And over here, on the left top side of the map, we are looking at the blue Protoss base. He is still your reigning champion. He can still make it to BlizzCon as well. Give it up for Big Baby.
And his opponent currently up 1-0 in this rematch of last season's grand finals. He's the Red Terran player representing Red Bull. He is Bomber. Oh, Bomber. You know, the thing is, like, he's always that guy that, especially in the other matchups, and I feel more so in Terran versus Zerg than any of the others, is where he busts out really crazy, weird strategies that don't really make sense to us, but, you know, like, Bomber's mind, like, he knows. And I'm wondering if at some point in this series we're going to see a build like that from one of these players.
Might actually open up with a Reaper over here, right? Or do you think it's going to be his reactor opening?
No, it looks like it's a regular setup for a Reaper.
Nothing, yeah, but that's already crazy. This is Bomber, Nate.
Oh, yeah, he's going to build a unit that can scout.
I'm a little bit in shock over here. Big Baby with a relatively quick scout over here as well. I think he will be very pleased to see that indeed there is a refinery.
He's like, Bomber's not going to have twice the economy at the beginning of the game. I'll already feel ahead.
Of course, there was a little bit of an unorthodox build as well from Pig Baby on Overgrowth, a robotics facility before a Nexus. No, that's not a standard at all. That's something that you do predetermined. It doesn't require any scouting. It doesn't mean that you adapt it to your opponent. Like, no, that's just set in stone. I want to do this build, and it really doesn't matter what you're doing. Of course, it was probably based on the fact that Bomber never scouts. And I think Bomber probably took a look at the match history. That's what every player does, right? As soon as you finish a game of StarCraft 2, you look at match history or build order history, and you're like, hey, Robo before Nexus? Like, this guy's cray. Maybe I should scout.
Well, I mean, if you're Bomber and you called the guy out hoping to play against him, and then you do this, you're like, okay, block your base. Bomber has had an idea, I imagine, of what strategies he wanted to go for on each map when this all began.
He often does that as well, because we spoke with him quite a bit, so we can talk about it. And when he was preparing for his Kespa Cup match against Rain, we asked, like, so, you know, like, how do you prepare for a match against Rain? You know, a guy that often looks like he doesn't really have a weakness. And Bomber's like, oh, I'm not too worried. I'm actually very confident. I got a specific build for every map, and I'm feeling pretty confident in that.
Look at this tweet. Must have been just before.
Yes.
Mr. Bitter is so handsome. I'm so happy he's here to cheer for me.
Yes.
If only we could all say that.
If only Mr. Bitter would ever contact me, I would be very happy to. I have the feeling that he may have taken control of Bomber's Twitter account, Nate. I'm just throwing it out there.
I wouldn't be surprised either. Reaper's going to show up. Sees Zealot working on some rocks. He's like, okay. Give him a little poke. Nothing crazy, though. He wants to, of course, see if Pig Baby's doing anything weird again this game. We know so far that's not really anything the Bomber has to be worried about.
The follow-up for Bomber, this is like, if I'm looking at this game and I don't have the name tags on, I'm not saying that I'm watching Bomber, Nate. Reaper Scout into a reactor with a factory follow-up. Of course, this is not a build that we've never seen before, but it's a build that we don't see very often from Bomber.
Okay, Bomber's making it into a Bomber build, though. Normally, this type of strategy is a very quick mind drop. Instead, it's going to be probably... Yeah. Wait. Oh, I feel like I've seen this.
I've seen it as well. I've seen it. Who was that? There was a Terran recently who
we
did
saw
it
something
on King Sejong Station.
We saw something like this.
Didn't MMA do this against Sun in a weird way? Or was it?
I was thinking about that 2 barracks build that Polt did against Parting with no starport and a lot of Hellions, but... I have a feeling this feels different still a little bit.
The base layout, it's very important to mention this as we look at the main base of Pig Baby. It looks like it's pretty okay against Hellions. If Hellions go in, they won't really get out anymore because of the Cybernetic Core placement. He could temporarily like drop a second pylon next to that one pylon that has the gateway.
And he could warp a Zealot in there.
Yeah, exactly. Like
off.
Just to mess with the AI. But it's very important if you play Protoss and there are Hellions on the map that you see that quickly. But Bomber's actually not going to do what we perhaps thought. He's just going to run two Hellions in and try to to kill a couple of probes.
That's not bad. I mean, you get...
He gets the photon overcharge as
well. Yeah, you get the photon overcharge. You get some information, but... Whoa, this Reaper. Whoa. Yeah. Whoa, this guy's balling out of control.
Bomber is like, I have a Reaper at the 7-minute mark. What do I do? Like, just send it in and try to kill something.
And you
I
get
guess.
A great scout, though. He's seen everything. He sees the forge, the robotics facility. And he's actually just being like, this Reaper just being a huge nuisance, Pig Baby.
Yeah, he distracted him there quite a bit. 4 probes went down. I think one of them was a scouting probe, but still.
I love how fast this build gives Bomber stim, though. Like, this is a pretty flimsy opening from the Terran because it gives you very few units, but those Hellions get your scout off. He's going to have his stim at like 8.5 minutes, and he's going to have medevacs close to popping out at the same time. And suddenly you get a 9 minutes. Marines are in your base. That's
nice, especially if we look at what is going on at Pig Baby's main base. You know, he's getting a Twilight Council, he's getting a robotics bay, and he has a force. Now you would say that all sounds very standard to me, and it is. But he's doing it all at the same time, so he's not gonna have a crazy amount of units to work with. Bomber, I think he's looking for observers. If he throws down a scan for this observer, I think that would be very important. But
I love how Bomber's mixed it up this game. This is a very...
It's a cool build, but this scout of Pig Baby is massive. Because now, if you're Pig Baby, you're like, all right, hey, I really need some units as well. Because if the guy starts dropping me soon, I won't have much.
Yeah, it's going to be very interesting to see how he moves forward here. Because he still only has two Stalkers and a Zealot.
And let's not forget...
First Colossus is...
And let's not forget that he already used the Photon Overcharge. Big Baby is actually pulling a real Pig Baby as he has 2 more observers in his natural that he's spreading out now.
And there's still a Widowmine in this drop too, so he needs to be very careful with the way he positions the army that tries to catch this drop.
Big Baby really doesn't have too many units. He has 1 Zealot and 2 Stalkers now and only 1 Photon Overcharge.
The Colossus is about almost to come out.
Yeah, but it's out of position. He's going to lose a bunch of probes here. Even a Photon Overcharge. I guess if the units are not dropped yet, it will get the job done.
I don't know if you want to drop on top of this.
All right. Saved by the bell.
Yeah, well, he immediately goes. He's planted down that third command center.
Yep.
And
yeah, I mean.
Bomber's still actually in a... This third command center feels so early. He's in a... I still love this position he's in.
Yep. Pig Baby is going to scout it with his observer, so that's nice for him. There are 4 additional gateways going down. And Pig Baby is sort of... he has 54 probes. 54 probes is too much for a 2 base.
I am impressed that he has the Colossus out in time to stop this after building 4 observers.
Yep.
He went pretty heavy on the observers this game.
He's pulling a real Pig Baby in that regard, that's for sure. As soon as Photon Overcharge runs out, there is 1 Marauder in that mix. And that 1 Marauder is already complicating things a little bit. Force fields. Man, that poor Widowmine. That was uncalled for.
He got locked in for life. boy. So I love how Bomber's just threatening with these medevacs everywhere, though.
What a random drop. 1 Widowmine, 2 Marauders, and 2 Marines.
He's like, walks in, he's like, okay, kill a couple probes, you can rip some zealots, I'll kill those, and then you can boost into these medevacs, try to go towards that main, and really what you just do is pull this army out of position. This medevac on the right side, he's really trying to just drag Pig Baby all around the map while simultaneously getting the rest of his upgrades back home.
Bomber is really taking advantage of the fact that Pig Baby just had very few units to work with. Like, if you get a Forge, if you get Blink Stalkers, if you go up to Colossus, and if you try, you know, you get an upgrade like Blink as well, and you get +1 armor and stuff, and you make 4 observers, you just don't have too many units. And Bomber is really taking advantage of the lack of units of Pig Baby, making this an 11, almost a 12-minute third Nexus, while he's already been mining of his 3 command centers. And that's definitely going well for Bomber.
Yeah, Bomber is getting all of these things that don't look like these big SCV pulled plays. And he's playing out really, really solid, just... Standard TVP, pulling him around with the drops, being aggressive. Up. And his Ghost Academy is actually done before the Templar Archives is even halfway finished. He's going to have Ghosts up way before Storm is even finished.
Do you think there's going to be a 3 Ghost SCV pool?
He could. I mean, there's no armory.
I mean, he's
armory.
Setting himself up for it.
There's no armory, and I think this actually, this play should work out phenomenally
well. I like
well.
That as
Snipes
well.
Snipes the Sentry, immediately picks up. Like, everything Bomber has done this game just... looks almost perfect.
Yep, because sentries are so important in defending SCV pools as well. Guardian Shield extremely important, and of course the force fields are invaluable. You need that kind of stuff because Terran is going to have more units. Now he does drop the armory, so...
Bomber. Doing. What are you going to do, you crazy
I think
man.
If he pulls SCVs now, he's in a fantastic position. There's no storm, there's not
there
going to be any storm.
Okay, the SCVs are on the way. He's going to pull all of his SCVs with this attack. Of course, he's going to soak up damage. There we go. The
look at this one guy. He's already been to war. Now he has to go again. He has like 5 HP left. I wonder if he makes it to the end.
Yeah, he's the guy that's making sure they don't get lost. He's like, guys, I've been to this place before. I know exactly where it is.
King Sejong Station is dark and full of Protoss. Be careful. I've seen it, Nick.
I mean, this is one of those maps where things can get tricky because you enter this one spot at the base of this ramp where the Protoss can defend both bases.
It's going to get tricky for Pig Baby though. He needs to make sure that he somehow keeps a couple of clusters alive. The Mothership Court almost dies immediately. Ooh, he moves the Vikings in very deeply. Of course, there's a lot of DPS in his Terran army. Will the Vikings kill all the Colossus?
Oh, those SCVs died almost instantly. Still, one Colossus stands. Bomber's army has taken a huge pummeling. That Archon doing some work. He's got 11 kills on one and 4 on the other. That plus 2 armor. Very nice.
He moved those Vikings in very, very deep. Now, obviously, that means that they're all the way committed, but I don't think that was necessary. I think he could have kept them a little further away, which would have been a lot harder for the Archons and the Starkers to pick them off. Because now one Colossus survived. If that Colossus doesn't survive, then Bomber can just start kiting. As Charge did finish up now, but there were barely any Zettles left anyway. But one Colossus changes everything.
Yeah, this is very tricky for a Bomber. I mean, I guess you still have that. You still have the 3 SCV production.
That Widowman actually got him.
That's a little unusual. He still has his 3 orbitals. It's like Bomber still actually has an income despite... He actually has an income lead despite that pull, so...
Does he have a second Starport, don't they? He doesn't, right? He got a very quick Ghost Academy, but... No second starboard. Normally when they pull SCVs, they do have a second starboard, but I kind of felt with the way that the game played out, it was okay for Bomber to try it regardless, but just an excellent hold by Pig Baby. Still questioned the Viking movement a little bit, because I felt they were on move command for a little longer than they should have been. And also, like, if a time warp goes down, I say it's a waste of a volley of Vikings to shoot at the Mothership Core and just go all the way. Like, if that full Viking goes on the Colossus, the Colossus probably dies.
This knows Pig Baby still just without... Without his gases at his third base.
But he always did that, no? And then he just adds a few more gateways.
This is pretty Pig Baby-esque. No plus 3 armor rush, though. And this is going to be that absurd number of charge lots with that handful of Stalkers.
He still doesn't really have any map presence on Bomber's side of the map. There's like no Warp Prism, there are no pylons over there. There's really no way for him to harass. One probe goes on an adventure and he will try to represent some sort of a potential threat to Bomber when he goes out on the map.
Yeah. It's going to daisy chain some pylons across. You can get some harassing. The Bomber's army is still very scary.
Yeah.
Army supplies is actually in favor of the Protoss, though, which is...
30, he has 39 Zealots, Nate.
That's a lot of Zealots, right? That is a lot.
Yeah, he has 76 supply in Zealots right now.
He doesn't even have that many Colossi. It's the Zealot. He's just trying to kill him with mass Zealots.
This is Braveheart style, man. He's just sending in all the Zealots. The Vikings starting to work on these Colossus again. I do not like this engagement for the Zealots, though. And the Colossus are not getting the shots up they need either.
Well.
We had 39 Zealots, but they're pretty much all gone. But the Vikings are gone as well.
Man. He's getting close. Only one Colossus left. There's still a lot of bio over. And if you guys wanted to see the tutorial on how to kill 40 Zealots, you've just been educated.
Look at these SCVs. They should right-click on the Colossus. Maybe they were able
to
disassemble it.
Those SCVs actually distracted it at first. This army would die in like 3 swipes from a Colossus.
I mean, I'm not sure. Bomber can't really push the issue here anymore, right?
No,
he has like no HP on his
arm. Consider that he pulled SCVs for a second time to do that too. Like
he could suicide maybe on the Nexus and then run away. But I don't think he should go for the natural. Like,
I mean,
that
Archon will one-shot all these workers.
Bomber is a little indecisive. A little, actually, very indecisive.
And the Observer sees everything.
Yeah, no, this is not a good idea, I think, for Bomber. A couple of Stalkers blink forward. That one Viking is going to fall. Zealots will do the job of tanking.
Get out of here, Bomber. Kiting against the Zealots is nice, but that Big Daddy Archon is still going to pick you off. And the Colossus. He really wants to remain aggressive out on this map, but when you only have 25 SCVs, you have to watch how much you're throwing away.
There's like no way that he can keep this. I mean, he still has a reasonable income because of all the mules that he's dropping, but he barely has any gas. Forward blink there by Pig Baby. The Archon is very low on HP. He should really kill the Archon. Kill the Archon. He doesn't care. GG is called. Pig Baby will even up the series. That was a very close game. I felt on 2 occasions it could have gone different for Bomber. I think the second time, that final fight against the 40 Zealots, like his bio positioning at the bottom of the ramp was beautiful, but he just didn't have the Viking numbers that he really needed. And as long as you don't kill the Colossus, you're going to have a hard time steamrolling a Protoss player.
Yeah, that game just... I mean, you said it with the mention on how those Vikings moved themselves. They just kind of They flew on top of the army, yeah. which wasn't really necessary. And then in a fight like this, if you just keep kiting, like standing, you know, stand and deliver is fine, but look how many waves of Marines the Colossus is able to kill because of that.
Yeah, and it's just, again, the Mothership Corps has been a true hero, by the way. He soaked up so many Viking shots, and the Colossus, they're just not dying, and they just push out too much damage. Eventually, the remaining Protoss units die, but as long as there is a Colossus, it just it gets complicated, and you can't really push the issue. These Zealots are really saving the day over here as well, allowing that Colossus to survive, allowing Pig Baby to fall back towards safety, and just getting that one more Archon. Really interesting fight. Two very interesting fights, which I think could have gone better for Bomber if his focus fire was a little better, or maybe you just have like two more Vikings, and I feel like everything could be different. But entertaining game for sure.
Yeah, this series has definitely delivered on the excitement that we were looking for. Very, very back and forth, both games.
Very evenly matched. Of course, Pig Baby still fighting for his BlizzCon dream as well. He doesn't want to have that title of being the only WCS champion ever not to be playing at BlizzCon.
Now that's not that's a title you don't want. It's definitely a second place that's going to hurtle. Well, I guess wouldn't even be if he lost here.
It's going to get very... It's such an interesting situation that we are currently in. Looking at that 16th spot in the WCS ranking, Jadong is sitting there. Jadong, all that Jadong needs is to make sure that Pig Baby loses in this tournament and Hero loses in this tournament. It doesn't really matter where they lose. Even if they lose in the grand final, he just needs to make sure, or he can't really do much about it, but he just needs to hope that they won't win this tournament. But they're both of them are on the bottom side of this bracket. Both of them are amazing Protoss players. It's a really, really interesting foresight, Nate. These two quarterfinals and, of course, the semis tomorrow as well. Unless both Protoss players lose here, but I'm not sure if that's going to happen.
It's certainly possible. I like Polt for TVP. I would bet on Polt TVP any day of the week. But this guy has... he's shown us some flexible openings after that last game, and I liked his position. Let's see if he can get back that lead. And Nimbus in the top left. He is in red. He matches that nice little red boat team he represents. He is Bomber.
And of course, on the left bottom side of Nimbus, we have the blue Protoss. He is currently teamless, but if he wins this tournament, maybe it will be different. Give it up for Pig Baby. Imagine, Nate. Imagine he wins this tournament as well. He would also be the first teamless player ever at BlizzCon. If he still doesn't get a team.
That's not a statistic I was actually looking at. That is interesting, Roddy.
We just keep finding them, Nate. We keep finding them.
There's all these interesting little nuggets of information that keep popping up. It's been a very interesting couple seasons. Pig Baby, he's just been an enigma, really. Like, Bomber, we know he's crazy, but Pig Baby, like, goes for really normal stuff. Like, that last game, he kind of just played out his regular style that we've seen him do time and time again. Heavy Observer opening, no gas on the third base.
Ooh.
Lots of Zealots.
Stargate actions, Nate. I'm sniffing a Stargate, but that Stargate is very far away. From
not in an ideal position to get...
I love that tweet, by the way. Thank you very much, Meta B.
Thanks.
Thank
Kappa.
You. I'm sure that Mr. Bitter is in the building somewhere, like, shedding a tear now. It's like, I know he's right.
we'll be crying together when it's all over.
Of course, a huge shout out to all the people at home, especially the Europeans that are still awake. We had tweets from New Zealand coming in, Australia. That is super cool. Anyway, so what is happening over here is that Pig Baby is like, you know what? There is a 66% chance that my opponent is either in the right bottom side or in the right top side of the map. I hope that he's in the right top side. So he's checking right now with a probe, and he's like, oh. Well, then he better be in the right bottom side. Because if he's in the left top side, because he's in the left top side of the map, it's not the end of the world, but it's just a few seconds difference. But that is the difference between perhaps your Oracle killing five SCVs or zero SCVs.
Is that Stargate really that much further than if he had just had it in his own base now with where Bomber spawned? Like,
I mean, it's not that much further, but it could have been a lot closer.
Yeah. So this Marine up front is going to delay this probe moving into, and Bomber... He did not go for, like, the craziest greedy build, which he's been known to do on this map, just like the one barracks, three command center. He will go right up to three
SCV,
barracks.
SCV on the right side of the map. It's pretty close, but he is...
I can't think of a reason why I would check there.
Because there is a Stargate, Nate. That's why.
Well, Your logic is irrefutable, Rotterdam. You have bested me in this game of wits.
There are six Marines out on the map. Six Marines is enough to fight an Oracle, but only if they're all together. If you send them in two by two, they will all die and they will not kill the Oracle. This Oracle will get a little bit of work done. But, ooh, there's a star. Okay, actually, there's no bunker yet. No, that's too many Marines to fly into Pig Baby. He messed up there a little bit. Of course, there is a little bit of energy left, so he still gets a few SCVs. What I'm worried about, Nate, is that he does... Oh, okay. That was not what I was worried about, but that's very good news for Bomber. But what is bad news for Bomber normally is that he doesn't have a bunker. If there is more gateway pressure behind this, like if this target is closer, that actually changes a lot. Now Big Baby is forced to expand because he knows that he's not going to be able to break this anymore.
Nope.
If this was in the right top side of the map, there is a good chance that Oracle fights four Marines, but still doing some work actually. Like imagine how bad this would have been if there would have been like two or three stalkers. Oh my
gets
god.
That's the second Oracle kill though. Wow. The third one is on the way now.
Yeah, this is not going very well for Big Baby at all. Like, killing Marines is nice enough.
Four SCVs for two Oracles, I would take that trade.
And let's not forget how incredibly late that Nexus is.
Yeah. Protoss additional probe production will be quite late later. Chronos for getting out your other things. Robo facility starts now. Gonna move on to the next phase of the game with a nice little lead for Bomber, who's actually building a bunker. He's like, just in case.
Yeah, which makes a lot of sense because if it would have been a tree gate behind that.
I mean, I'll tell you all about that, Roddy. That's the part where you start to worry about the health of your keyboard after that game's over.
Yeah, that's the moment where you hope your keyboard wasn't too expensive, right, Nate? You have to tweet at your sponsor, like, oh, I spilled some coffee or something like that.
It smashed the keyboard in half, but it was a spill, I promise.
I dropped coffee on my keyboard and all the buttons flew out and I can't push them back.
Robotics facility is finishing up. A scan will see it. Bomber been playing very proactively with his scouting this game as the third Oracle swoops in, grabs three kills.
Nice Oracle movement there, by the way, because it's very...
Wow.
I mean, he does a really good job
starts
in avoiding...
Starts a fourth Oracle! He's like, man, I will have an Oracle on this map, damn it! At some point, you gotta ask yourself, how much is too much? Does he even have... Okay, he's got a Mothership Core.
He has a Stalker, a Sentry, and a Mothership Core against 22 Marines.
You know what? 22 Marines is a force to be reckoned with when that Stalker is out on the map, too. That bad boy gets caught.
Like, it's so silly because the Oracle movement at first was actually sort of beautiful because he keeps it away from the Marines and he still moves and shoots at the same time. And it's very easy to make your Oracle float closer towards the Marines and it's easy to mess this up. Like, Protoss players, we all have lost Oracles we shouldn't have lost.
Whenever I proxy Stargate, it just dies, right?
All right, let's see how number four does. I think he's just building up to number seven, and that will be the...
He's not looking up his ramp! Two sentries close to dying. Bomber's like, damn these rocks. Okay, so that could have been epic. The Oracle only got one kill in Bomber's base.
I mean, these Marines...
Bomber's like, I will get in your base. I know you don't have anything up here, man. I know you've got nothing.
Yeah, and if you fold it over, charges into
May. Oh, Marines are squeezing through. Even these bad boys are enough to fight this. You have no units, Pig Baby. Bring Oracle number five back!
Marines will stay. The thing is, if he Photon Overcharges in his main, he can't protect his natural.
Yeah, this is awkward. Yeah. Palmer's like, okay, you still have no units, buddy. My god, probes! Boom, boom, boom!
Couple of Zealots will sort of. No, actually, two Zealots might not be enough. Oh, he's warping in one by one. That's really bad. More probes will fall over here.
Oh my god, Ryan. Aaron Dream right here, man. Is it wrong if I say I'm enjoying watching this?
Is this what Terran Dreams are made of, mate?
When you get proxy oracled, every Terran Dreams is just walking into their base and killing everything.
So this is what you think. Okay, one Oracle was able to find in a small opening over there, but 48 SCVs against 31 probes. There are more Terran units in this base, by the way. Both an overcharge and a Colossus is a little too much to deal with for now. Yeah, what's wrong with that Colossus?
He was like, he's derping, man.
He's like, forgot how to use my legs.
You okay? You okay, buddy?
Oh, well. Pretty entertaining game so far. Oracle number four did survive.
So far, I am pretty entertained by this series.
I don't think Big Baby is very entertained, though.
Not after the way this game started. Oh.
I can guarantee you if you make four Oracles and you only have one left at the 11-minute mark, something went wrong.
Yeah. I mean, it hasn't been ideal for him.
No, don't
you still have no army! It's a Colossus, yes, but is he gonna drop on top? No.
Yeah, like Bomber can actually just drop these units on top of the Colossus and kill it.
I want it to happen just for the comedic effect at this point.
Okay, well, if flying into the natural is a pretty good move as well when when the entire army consisting of four units is in the middle of the map. Oh, there is a Photon Overcharge, so that will save the day a little bit.
I like just clicking on the workers. Nexus tries to target down the medevacs, which is smart, but you lose your expensive stalkers. He still gets away.
No.
Okay.
Oh,
poor Marauder.
He forgot Ryan.
Poor little guy. Couldn't quite fit in there, Roddy. Bomber has two starports already? Like, he's got everything.
I know.
I feel like we're like, you know, things are happening slowly. Pig-Baby slowly gets out of his Colossus. Bomber's like, actually, no, I've got pretty much everything I need to just win the game right now.
I mean, he was up like 15 SCVs. That's pretty insane for
considering
Terran versus Protoss.
Yeah, considering how good mules are normally. Yeah. When you're up on the actual harvesters that take supply, things get weird.
I mean, Pig-Baby is about to attack. And if he wins this, then we could say that he has truly pulled the biggest Protoss of all time. And we hope that QXC isn't watching on his birthday, because he will not enjoy it. But
no.
I have a hard time imagining that he's able to somehow force field his way to victory over here. But maybe if Bomber move commands his Vikings again.
I mean, if he move commands everything, there's hope. He does have three Colossi. I mean, sweet dreams are made of this. Okay, gets one nice volley off, paling all the shields. Two Colossi stand. The first force fields, I'm not sure Bomber needs to go down this ramp. Just keep killing stuff that tries to go up it.
Viking Nom is still four. He has to be a little bit careful about it. He's working on the last Colossus.
One Colossus, yeah, this gateway army is just paper mache, and he's a chainsaw. GG, Bomber, up 2-1. Here is WCS America, quarterfinal number 3. This series delivers, Roddy.
That's one of those games that you won't forget for a while. Not because it was the most amazing StarCraft you've ever seen, but just because it was something that you don't see very often.
No,
I love how persistent he was.
The thing
though is,
he never built an Oracle until the other one had died.
Yeah,
it wasn't like, I'm gonna build four Oracles, let me queue them up as the other one finishes. It was, I build an Oracle, oh, it died. Okay, build another one. And then it just kind of happened like that. He never had the immediate Oracle follow-up, which is one of the things that allows you to move 22 Marines out of your base.
Yes. And then at a certain point, it's like, well, you know, these Oracles, last time I checked, they're pretty expensive. And the first one also showed up very quickly. Let's not forget, something I didn't mention yet, but that was a second pylon proxy Stargate. Like, that kind of cripples your economy a little bit. That definitely hurts early on, sending a probe out that early and putting just all your money into a Stargate, into an Oracle, and having your Nexus that late. Then losing those Oracles is just really painful. It all started with that first Oracle, because it was really funny. It could have flown into the natural, and it would have had a free mineral line. It could have flown into the main base, it would have had an exposed mineral line. The only place it shouldn't have flown were the six Marines that were standing next to the two barracks, but that's exactly where number one went, and he did not live very long.
You know, in certain situations, I've had games where Protoss players that think you might have units in your mineral line, you know, they'll go a little Maximus Black on you. They'll be like, you probably don't have anything at your ramp, though. And they'll go kill, like, the three Marines that are there while that Stalker pushes the front. And then their three gateways finish you off. But Pig-Baby, with one gate, didn't have an opportunity to capitalize on any of the workers that he killed. And, well,
the additional gates were also very late, but I guess that's because he...
Well, he went straight into his Robo, too, after the Nexus.
I really think if Obama would have been at the right top side of the map, then I think he adds two more gateways.
Gets really tricky for him, I agree.
Yep, the moment he sees, all right, no bunker yet, Oracles, I'm going to keep making Oracles, I'm going to follow this up Oracle Gateway, and pure Marines should not be able to survive against
it. It's a solid 20-second delay that definitely allows the Terran player to squeeze out another wave of Marines from that three barracks opening.
Anyway, Nate, we enjoyed that game. It seems like everybody here enjoyed that game as well, and I think that Jadong at home enjoyed that game too, because Pig-Baby right now, one map away from being eliminated, which means that Jadong would only have to worry about one other player knocking him out of BlizzCon. But he's not there yet. Pig-Baby is a man of comebacks. We saw it last season.
Yeah, he's going to try to make it happen here in WCS America Season 3. He's our blue Protoss spawning in the top right position of Deadwing. He has no team, but he's been on top. He is Pig-Baby.
Over here on the right bottom side of the map, the man, he was aiming for revenge, and so far he's on track. Give it up for Red Bull's Bomber. For Bomber, this is something that we went over earlier today as well. Of course, it's hard because nothing is really set in stone yet. But the way that things currently shape up, and in some scenarios, if nothing changes, then Bomber would play against Su in the round of 16.
Oh.
And that's something that I think most Terrans would rather avoid, unless you're Innovation perhaps, but let's say that
Su is... Unless you were seeded into the grand final to play Su.
Yes.
Then you're not concerned.
Oh, too soon, Nate, too soon. But good point, though, good point. Point made. But if Bomber would win this, then it would already change things a little bit, and I think then he would be projected to go up against Jokji, and I think that's something, especially after defeating Cure 4-0, something he would feel a lot more comfortable with. So, of course, besides money and prestige, there is definitely seeding on the line. For some players, you know, some players might make it worse for themselves if they get more points, but I think for Bomber, it's safe to say that you don't want to play Su in the round of 16.
Yeah. I'm very interested to see if Bomber continues to mine two SCVs on gas if we see that factory play again, which on Deadwing is not so bad. You have a long distance to go to scout anything. Hellions are fast units. You can get in there nice and quick. You have a relatively large entrance to your natural that the Hellions can squeeze by. Protoss players don't wall off their front, so if you can slip into the main, you can see what's up. But Bomber, okay, he's actually taken all of his workers off gas now that this command center's ready to go. So it seems we're going to have about as standard of a game as we can get out of our Terran player here.
Yep. Once more, Bomber opening up with that Reaper like you mentioned, which is funny because we casted multiple series where 5 games in a row he didn't make a single Reaper and didn't even move out up to the 9-minute mark in the game. But Bomber changing up his playstyle a little bit, making sure that he's not becoming too predictable, and that's of course nice to see. Big Baby on the other end also opening up very standard. He had the Zealot queued up just in case there would be an Engineering Blade block once more.
It's so cool because Bomber is usually that guy that we would say is really stubborn. Even playing a Red Bull, like, yeah, he's stubborn. He's greedy. Dong Ray Goose said it in his interview before he lost to him being greedy 2 games in a row. You know, he's Mule King. He just spams out his mules all the time. He doesn't really focus on the scouting. But this series, Bomber, and I think it has to do with that challenge he threw out. When you call someone out that I want to play you so that I can wreck you in the rematch, you do not pull any punches. And if you can get Bomber to scout, you've probably pissed him off.
Yeah, it's been a while. It must go back to 2012, I guess, to see that happen. This Reaper is going to go on a small journey, wants to make sure there is no Stargate again hidden somewhere on the map, or maybe a crazy Twilight Council or something like that. But that's not the case. So far, everything is very standard. I think this is the type of map where We would see Pig Baby do what Pig Baby does best, and that is make a lot of observers and just try to stabilize on 3 bases. Maybe rush up to that armor upgrade once more like we saw in the past, but maybe he kind of just faded away from that and he likes his attack upgrades a little more now again.
Well, Deadwing's a pretty good map for 3 base play. Yes. So I don't think there's...
Probably the best one out there, right?
Yeah,
Reaper is gonna
die. It's a pretty safe argument to say that Pig Baby could very easily do the same strategy he did on King Sejong Station, albeit defensively.
Wow.
That Reaper.
That Reaper. Jukes of Hazard. I thought I was going to die, but it lived.
It's a good feeling, man.
Bomber may not scout very often, but when he does, Nate...
It always feels like you're the director of like some sick action movie whenever you have your Reaper running around. You're like, is it going to make it? And then it just barely gets out. And Protoss tells you something mean in chat. And you're like, well, it's okay.
Bomber, of course, opened up with 3 Rexes, which is giving him access to a lot of bio units early on. I don't really expect him to march across the map with them, because even though Deadwing has a very wide ramp, but it's also such a large map that it's very easy to see as a Protoss that this is coming. And if you just throw away those units, you're going to have a hard time making your follow-up push in a later stage in the game very intimidating.
You think Bomber got in Pig Baby's head a little bit? He's opened up with just Stalkers, and he has a cannon in his natural.
Yeah. I mean, Tournament Live is on the line. Everything is on the line over here for Pig Baby. These units will actually march out. And of course...
Combat Shield is his opening, so actually this cannon is a really smart idea. And the Stalkers have a lot of space to maneuver with.
One sentry, I don't really like that because a sentry doesn't really add anything. Either you have multiple sentries or you don't have any at all.
I feel like the cannon and the Nexus with the Photon Overcharge are more than enough
to
combine.
Is the Mothership Core in position though? Yeah, it is. Okay, good positioning on the Mothership Core.
This really shouldn't do anything.
Nope.
If Bomber were to scan ahead, I think you back off. But now it's a bit weird. Kill the cannon and get out of there. Yeah, sticking around isn't going to accomplish much. And he immediately rebuilds 2. He's like, nope. 3?
Oh, wow.
What?
I mean, I guess that push still accomplished something.
You know, the first time I started to play Protoss against Terran and these pushes hurt me, I'm like, yeah, let's build like five cannons. And I lost, you know, I lost to a drop. Big Baby's like, well, I really don't want to take any frontal damage here.
Look at this observer madness over here. Like, one scan could have...
It's happening!
It's a bummer. If only you knew how close you were to two more.
I mean, those observers are lined up in like a triangle, man. Yeah. This is pretty much the Illuminati Protoss.
It is real, isn't it? The next wave will probably have Stim, but there should be a Colossus out as well. Now if he adds in another... man, these cannons may actually come in very handy.
You know, we were a little bit perplexed that he built like seven photon cannons in his natural against Tasia.
Yeah, but then Tasia dropped
in it. And then Tasia Doom dropped into seven photon cannons.
Big Baby, he has like this aura around him. It's just like this attack me aura when you shouldn't.
Perhaps. Well, it also worked against him with his Oracle flying straight into the only place that was defended against Oracles.
He's a special one, that's for sure. But Bomber is not going to go in once more. He's just going to retreat. He has a lot of Marines. Of course, going to be good for dropping. It's not going to be very useful in a straight-up engagement against the heavy Colossus number. I have the feeling that Pig Baby is aiming for in this game. Observer is,
Observer madness.
This is Pig Baby. How we remember him. Man, I would love to see this go to game 5, though. This would be... that would be pretty epic.
It would be quite fitting for these two.
Yep, considering the history that they have. More gateways going down as well. Stalkers are in the right position. Blink is not ready yet, so it needs to make sure that he's on top of his stalker position. But so far, he definitely is.
Well, I mean, when the observer sees everything, you're not. It's not too difficult. Though, I mean, if those units unload, it gets weird, right?
Yeah,
but the Colossi are also... Enough. The Colossi are being kept in a weird position because there's three photon cannons to cover your front, so... Now the Colossi could run into the main if they really needed to. It prevents you from dropping somewhere else in the main base.
Very quick second stopper though, this game by Bomber. I sort of missed it. I didn't really see it, or, you know, I saw it, but I didn't really...
It's pretty similar to the time that he got it on the last map, too. It's, it's only interesting because that third base area, it's like, yeah, it's a very close third, but it takes quite a few force fields, and because of the way that we've seen him do this build so many times, Pig Baby with only two sentries, he's quite limited as far as his force fields go.
I really feel that this is an SCV pool map for Bomber. He hasn't really done a whole lot. This is like a very typical Bomber game. He's up in army supply. He has no armory yet. He doesn't have a second engineering bay either. He might drop in Ghost Academy just for three ghosts, but I feel that Bomber often does this without ghosts as well. The Templar Archives is going down. I think if Bomber scouts this, there's like 99% sure that he's going to pull the SCVs and tries to win before there is like... four or five High Templars with Storm. This base, despite this being an easy map for three bases, Nate, is still pretty late. 12 minutes and 30 seconds. It's not like Pig Baby has a ridiculous amount of gas to work with.
Yeah. And considering that the observers still see his army, it makes things interesting. He's had rallied back into his base.
He has to pull them.
He's got Vikings. Is it happening? Is he going to bring his SCVs?
Yep. I think it's almost inevitable.
Wait. I mean, I
mean, he doesn't even have a third command center.
Yeah, he has no armory either. I wouldn't mind an SCV train. The observer sees it coming, though. He has his army. His observer on top of the whole army.
He has to do this because if this attack wouldn't work, then he's dead anyway. He has no armory. He has no follow-up. He has no third command center. So Bomber is going to put all his eggs in one basket. The Viking count is currently at... I'm really worried though.
That plus two armor is going to finish again. Yeah. And he has Archons. This is exactly like that position that he was in.
I'm not sure.
On King Sejong Station, and he cancels the third Nexus.
Yeah, why not?
You have to attack into photon cannons now.
That's actually pretty smart. Two base against two base.
I think this is a phenomenal position for Pig Baby.
What a good call there. A very, very early photon overcharge as well.
Bomber,
Bomber is still going to go for it.
This is really abusing Bomber's stubbornness because he's like, I know you're still going to attack me anyway.
Yeah, force fields could be very good there. The Vikings are pretty clumped up. Look at these Archons, Nate. These Archons can get a couple of good shots off. Two out of three Colossus are dead yet, though, but a couple of the bio units start falling as well. The last Colossus is going to fall.
There's not enough Zealots he doesn't have enough Zealots to actually meat shield against this. He's bringing the probes out.
No.
The Archons are the real firepower here. The other Archon gets baited to the right side by these Marauders. Keep in mind, if he can hold this off, he's lost all his workers, but when you have to lose your own probes, it gets equally dicey.
Yep. He has charge as well. He still has that one cannon. He still has the photon overcharge as well. He's hanging in there. Army supply is getting closer and closer. Blink as well. For now, Pig Baby lives. But like Nate mentioned,
Workers are equal, man. Workers are equal. It's 30 probes to 25 SCVs with two mules.
Imagine if he would... You think he has the money to research Storm?
I'm not sure where you go, because I feel like if Pig Baby...
Just Charizard Icon. It's pretty good in low eco situations.
I mean, consider that there's still no armory for Bomber. You take it slow.
You know,
and if you could even squeeze out like plus three armor, then your units are unkillable, because he can never get plus two attack.
There is no more Photon Overcharge.
Oh,
so, okay, the last SCVs are being pulled as well. There's no more Photon Overcharge, and Photon Overcharge was definitely a big playmaker in that last fight. So
here we go.
It's going to get tricky. 71 army supply against 45. It will be hard. That one Photon Cannon needs to stay alive, needs to push out a lot of damage. I would really love to see one more Archon.
That cannon has nine kills, man. He's racking him up. Finally killed the Zealot. Step in. Guardian Shield with that armor upgrade is a big deal.
Misclick on the rocks there by Bomber, losing a little bit of potential DPS. Zealots are sort of pushing it back, but the Zealot count is dwindling as well. The Medivacs are being picked off, and that is really good news if you're Pig Baby.
Still two Archons alive. These bad boys.
You need Zealots.
These bad boys lay waste to these Marines.
So close.
Probes pulled once again. Needs to get rid of the Archon too. Gets it. I mean, if you kill the probes
so
and he can't build Zealots, what do you do?
Yeah, that's true, but
he
still.
He has mules. He does. If he can trade out for workers at this point, you can't really be counterattacked.
One more stim and his entire army is like one hit away from dying. All these Zealots, every single time they charge, they die. The Stalkers.
All I do is stim, no matter what, Roddy. And I think he still has a chance to make this work, because there's no more economy. You can't build those beefy Zealots.
There is one more Archon being morphed in now, but like you mentioned, I think Pig Baby should send some of the pros from his main tower to his natural, because they're probably like not really mining anymore.
This medevac, because of how low econ this is.
This medevac rains gold.
Yeah, man, every Marine that gets healed, this is just money in the bank that he doesn't have to actually mine or spend. It's making his army so much more beefy, and Pig Baby can't afford to warp anything in.
It's almost impossible for Pig Baby. He just doesn't have the economy like you mentioned. He still has that one cannon. It would be really nice if that cannon can somehow participate in the fight.
Yeah.
That one Archon is getting a little exposed
Archon has to be the playmaker.
Yeah.
When it's dead, Stalkers, they just die, Roddy. Picking them off, focusing them down. Probes are not going to win a battle for you in a situation like this. Bomber continuing to just... I love this cute little drop play, too.
Look at that one Zealot chasing after those two Marauders.
I can do it, guys.
The Zealot might get a feedback as well on the medevac. One more Archon morphing in. Pig Baby really trying to hang in there. The Marauder gets dropped again.
Look at this.
This is Marine Micro Challenge over here. It's like the Blizzard Challenge that you need to do to get an achievement.
Archon chases the Marauder, but only hit points. He gets picked off. Bomber's winning
too
this
much
game.
Darren. The power of the mule, Nate.
Yeah, man.
Power of the mule. You can pull SCVs all day, every day.
Fire up the SCV train, ride home on the mule train, baby.
Yeah. Poor Pig Baby. He's really hanging in there. His BlizzCon dream is on the line. But I'm afraid it's going to end over here when there's only one Eye Templar that doesn't have Storm.
GG!
That is going to be it.
Bomber is going to advance onto the semifinals of the World Championship Series America Season 3. Pig Baby, the runner-up who defeated him last year in the grand finals, has been knocked out.
Yep. Oh, poor Pig Baby. He will be the first WCS champion ever not to make it to BlizzCon. Bomber did get the revenge that he has been working for so hard and just keeps up his amazing consistent results over the last few months. It's pretty impressive what Bomber is doing over the last few months. He's like one of the older players. He often says as well, like, yeah, I'm getting older. I'm a little slow. It's like, no, Bomber, you're still really, really good at this game.
Bomber just, I don't know, man. That guy, he is just so confident all the time. And every time he ever talks bad about anything, he wins anyway. You said it. It seems like every time we cast him, he's actually just like winning. Except against Pig Baby last season, and now he's...
Yeah, but that was like a runner-up. That was still very good.
So you only finished second place in the regional grand final.
It's been an amazing run so far for Bomber, and his run will continue. I definitely think that J-Dung threw up another small fist pump, Nate, as there is now only one player remaining that can prevent J-Dung from participating at BlizzCon this year and try to do... J-Dung obviously will try to do the same thing as he did last year, or perhaps even go all the way. As he got so close, and now he has to hope to make it to BlizzCon, but so far it's looking good. For now, I want to hear from Bomber, as I see that he's sitting over with James and Cameron. So guys, take it away.
Thank you very much, Roddy. Bomber, you predicted this during the round of 16. You told Pig Baby, I want you to get to the round of 8, but not in the winner's bracket so that I can beat you. How are you feeling now that that's all come true?
최진 선수 일단 준결승 올라가시면 축하드리고요. 그리고 16강 이제 끝나고 진출자들 인터뷰 소감했을 때 그때 이제 양희 선수한테 영상 메시지 보냈었잖아요. 2등으로 올라오라고. 2등으로 올라와서 이제 8강에서 결국 누르게 되셨는데 뭐 이제 다시 이제 구현을 한 만큼 뭐 소감 말씀 들어보겠습니다.
일단 제가 바라던 대로 양희수 선수가 올라오고 그리고 그 말대로 이겨서 정말 기분이 좋고 오늘 좀 컨디션이 안 좋아서 좀 경기력이 좀 안 좋았던 것 같은데 다행히 좀 쉽게 이긴 것 같아요.
I'm happy that what I said happened and I didn't like I was able to make out of from what I said from the round of 16. And I know I played a very scrappy game. So if any of you, if your eyes been hurting, I apologize. I hope you accept it.
Now, it was a very scrappy series, but it did seem as though you were the one setting the tempo, being the aggressor in the series. Did you feel in control the entire time?
뭔가 아까도 경기력이 좀 안 좋았었던 것 같았다, 컨디션이 좀 안 좋았었던 것 같았다라고 말씀을 하셨는데 일단 모든 경기를 다 봤을 때 일단 페이스 부분인 적인 면에서는 최인 선수가 항상 이제 경기를 리드를 하셨었고 항상 첫 번째 무브도 하시고 이랬는데 뭐 sorry, what was the second part of the question?
Did you feel as though you were in control throughout the series?
이제 리드를 하셨는데 확실하게 경기력이 안 좋지만 그래도 내가 여전히 뭐라 그래야 되지? 주도권을 잡고 있었다라고 생각을 하셨는지.
근데 뭐 그 부분에 대해서는 제가 원래 공격적이고 올인성 플레이도 자주 하기 때문에 상대 선수가 위축된 플레이를 한 것 같고 그리고 뭐 평소에도 그런 식으로 하는 것 같아요. 아니 그냥 내 게임이 자체가
On that note, I am oftentimes I am the more aggressive player. I am the one that always sets the pace in pretty much all matches. So I think it's just played out the way I normally do. So yeah.
All right, nothing new from Bomber then from that regard.
New.
Now your spot at BlizzCon is 100% secure, but your seeding is not 100% secure. And I'm interested in knowing this. In a tournament as stacked as BlizzCon is, with as many high-quality players, is the difference between a higher seed and a lower seed really that significant, or is every single match going to be testing all of your skill?
최인선 선수, 이 경기와 사실 무관하게 블리스콘은 진출 확정을 하신 건데 위치는 아직 정해진 게 아니잖아요. 이번 시즌 대회에서 어떤 성적을 거두느냐에 따라서 순위가 바뀔 수도 있기 때문에 그거에 대한 이제 뭐 딱히 뭐 난 어느 정도가 좀 더 편하겠다. 왜냐하면 사실 전 세계적으로 이제 최강 16명을 모으는 거기 때문에 순위가 중요하다고 생각하십니까?
어차피 목표가 우승이기 때문에 뭐 순위나 뭐 대진표 이런 건 별로 크게 신경을 안 쓰는 편이지만 가능하면 뭐 그래도 테란을 만나고 싶어요.
The objectives of going to the BlizzCon is to take the entire thing. So the seeding really doesn't matter because I'm going to be facing off against you know the best of the best that win on top of those guys too. So it doesn't really matter to me, but I think I'd prefer playing against Terrans.
Playing against Terrans, okay. Go ahead.
그리고 제가 4강에서 질 경우에 정지훈 선수랑 하게 되는데 만약에 내일 4강에서 저도 기분이 상당히 좋을 것 같아요.
Now that I've advanced, even if I lose, pretty much guaranteed that I would be going up against Jakchi, who is a Terran. So I think I'd be happy even if I get knocked out tomorrow early on.
So since you say you prefer going against Terrans, are you rooting for Pult in the next series because you will be playing tomorrow, the winner of Pult versus Hero.
아까 말씀하신 대로 하면은 그 짝지 선수랑 지금 돼 있는데 그 다음 경기인 송현도 선수랑 최성훈 선수 경기에서 최성훈 선수가 올라오면은 더 올라갈 거고 순위가 그럼 포인트도 또 올라가야 되니까 짝지 선수를 안 만나게 되는 건데 그럼 도대체 이 그 다음 매치에서 누구를 원하실 겁니까?
뭐 아무나 올라도 상관없긴 한데 저는 태태전이 개인적으로 자신 있기 때문에.
Doesn't matter who really advances in the next match.
That's the bomber we all know and love. Thank you very much for your time. Really appreciate it. Let's check back in with the casters, gentlemen.
Always nice to hear from Bomber, and it's pretty much how Cam Dozer put it. That's the Bomber we know.
That's just how he rolls.
But, you know, during all that, in between the lines, he did say, like, yeah, I'm probably playing Jogji, so that's a little better for me. Like, I think he did look at the predictions as well. He's like, Sue, I better win against Big Baby, even though I already planned on doing that. Like, yeah, it actually helps me in more than one way.
Bomber's TVT looked pretty sharp at Battlegrounds DC. I don't think Jogji is a bad matchup for him at all. I mean, both of those players honestly should be pretty happy with that matchup.
Yeah, exactly. It's one of those scenarios where if you're Jogji, you're probably like, well, you know, Bomber, it could have been worse. And Bomber probably looks at it like, well, Jogji, it could have been a lot worse. So it goes two ways. Of course, all 16 players that will be at BlizzCon, no one is going to be easy, but there is definitely that like upper echelon that you rather avoid at first. And like I feel as well, like if you say Bomber in the semifinals will probably have more confidence than Sue. Like in the round of 16, I feel that Sue's often... You know, obviously, like he lost a lot of finals and stuff, but Bomber is so experienced. He's already won so much money throughout his career that he doesn't really think about those things, and he can truly only focus on the game. So it can definitely make a difference in which round you play a certain player.
Yeah, I agree. I think it's also, like, when you look at the way that the matchups get played, Sue, I mean, you just think about it. Sue's an aggressive Xur. We look back to that final that he dropped against Innovation. Very aggressive builds up throughout. Bomber, he likes to be greedy in that matchup, at least. I don't know if you want to play versus someone that's known for being a little bit more on the cheddar side of the wheel. Just kick things off.
Oh, well, it's been a long day already of StarCraft 2. Of course, we have one more quarterfinal ahead of us. That is going to be such a cool one. That is also a rematch. We have to go back a little further in time, though, as one of the first tournaments in 2014 was the Intel Extreme Masters in Cologne. That tournament was the era of Protoss. It was a beautiful game back then. We all loved it. There was a lot of Blink Stalker harass, provided really entertaining games. Right, Nate?
There were... Yeah, and you know, Yansu is in the map. And Heavy
We had
Rain.
Yansu, Heavy Rain, beautiful maps to see beautiful Protoss play. However, back then, Hero was able to defeat Polt 4-2 in the Grand Finals, and it was an achievement on its own that Polt made it to the Grand Finals because he had to defeat a lot of excellent Protoss players to get there, and it was a pretty difficult thing to do. Now this is a different day and age. We will see if Hero is going to be able to do that once more, or is Paul's finally going to have his sweet revenge. But before we do that, of course, we're going to throw it over to our very own Joshua Clutch Gray once more.